Python is a very powerful programming language. With the help of Python programming language, we can develop software, we can create mobile applications, we can develop ML applications and even AI applications and then neural network applications. Like, we can develop many more things. With the help of Python, even we can do scientific calculations. Today we are going to learn the fundamentals of Python. Before going to the topic, let me discuss one main point. When we start learning of new programming language, we should know the language fundamentals. The language fundamentals In language fundamentals, we are going to learn about what is Python, applications of Python, features of Python, limitations of Python, flavors of Python, Python versions, Python identifiers, Python keywords. These are the main topics in the Python basics or Python fundamentals. Before going to main topics, we have to learn these topics. Every programmer or every student should learn this one. What is Python? Python is a high-level programming language. High-level means programmer-friendly language, not computer-friendly language. It seems that here I have given an example. See, here I have given an example. What is high-level? High-level. Let me take an example. A is equal to 10, B is equal to 20, C is equal to 30. If A greater than B, else 40. See here, the printer, the output has came 40 because of the A is not greater than B. See how simple it is. Even a small very kid also can understand this one. It is a general purpose programming language. A Python is concise code and simple. See here, it is simple code. See here, it is simple code. It is simple code, but it is very short and simple. That is why the Python is concise code and simple. Python language is dynamically typed. By default, it can adjust a garbage collectors like many of the stuff we can discuss in later on sessions. The dynamically typed languages are Python, JavaScript, and etc. It seems that you can ask what you have told dynamically typed languages. Can you give an example for statically typed? The statically typed languages are C, C++, Java. These are the statically typed languages. Applications of Python. When we are going to learn about the Python programming language or any programming language or any other application in our life, we have to learn the applications. What we can do with that, what we can do with certain programming language. For Python, we are going to learn about For Python, the applications of Python is we can use Python to develop desktop applications. We can develop web applications like Gmail, Facebook, WhatsApp, web, and etc. Network applications like chatting applications like WhatsApp, Messenger, Hike, Signal app, like that. We can develop also network applications. We can use Python for game development, Python for and data analysis. We can use Python for machine learning, deep learning, neural network, artificial intelligence, Internet of Things. In these aspects only, the Python is taken a very boom area. Due to these fields only, Python has warmed up. Let me take which companies are using Python. Google for recommendation systems and many more. Spotify, Yahoo, Netflix, Quora, Dropbox, Facebook, NASA. See how such big companies are also using. Government organizations are also using NASA. Features of Python. It is simple and easy to learn. It is freeware and open source. Hold on here. All the people know that simple, free and open source. free means we can learn freely, we can use freely, like Java, like C Sharp. But they are not open source. When you are going to develop any of the, when you want to modify the source code of the C Sharp or Java, you want to take the permissions from the C Sharp owners or Java owners. For Java, Sun Networks and C Sharp, Microsoft is own. When you want to rewrite a source code of C Sharp or Java, you have to pay certain amount of money. But when it comes to Python, we need not to pay any single amount, or even a single dollar, or single rupee, or single euro. We need not to pay any single amount. That's why it is very popular. Then a platform independent. When we develop any application in Windows, it can run on Mac OS, it can run on Linux, it can run on Android. Probability and portability. It seems like a platform independent only. The portability means when we develop an application in one platform, it will automatically perform in another platforms also, and dynamically typed. It is interpreted. See, the Python is a interpreted programming language. Interpreted means, let me take an example of C programming language. C programming language is a compiler, based on compiler. The whole program should be compiled at once, and if the any error has occurred in 10th line, the before 9th line and 8th line won't be executed. When it comes to Python, the error has been occurred in 10th line, the from 0th line to 9th line, it will be executed, and 10th line only occurred error. Then it is extensible. It is embedded, and Python has an extensible library. Due to this library support only, Python has been very popular and high level programming language. Limitations of Python. We have to know that when we learn any programming language, we have to know limitations of Python. What we can do with Python, what we cannot do with Python, this and all stuffs, do's and do nots. For mobile applications, it is not suitable because of there is not library support. Enterprise applications like banking applications or telecom applications, because of in that field only, in that field also, there is not such library support. Performance is not up to the mark because of it is interpreted. It is the performance of Python programs is slow. To improve the performance, the developers has introduced a JIT compiler. It seems that just in time compiler. Then that just in time compiler flavor is called as PyPy, Python for speed. Python has several libraries in the areas where the ML applications are neural network applications. In most of the ML applications are neural network or artificial intelligence, these high level things in data science, we always use these libraries: NumPy, Pandas, Matplotlib, scikit-learn, this and all stuff. Flavors of Python. C Python to work with C language applications. When it comes to data science, in the data science aspects, at certain time we have to work with C applications also. At the time we can work with C Python to run C language code also. Then JPython. It has an ability to work with Java applications. Iron Python to work with C Sharp and .NET applications. Ruby Python to work with the Ruby applications. Anaconda Python, it seems that it is an mobile desktop application. Anaconda Python has a huge name in in developers. Like it can handle very large amount of data. For data science or NML or neural networks, these data science can handle these data science aspects. The data science scientists are will work with a huge amount of data only. For this aspects, the Anaconda Python we are going to use, like Jupyter Notebook, that's and all. And there is another flavor, PyPy. It seems that Python for speed. Python versions. Basically, the first version is Python 0.9.0, February 12th, 1999. And the first version is 1.0 on January 1994. The second version is 2.0 on October 16th, 2000. The third version, it seems that 3.0, December 3, 2008. You may think, are any Java background people or any Java background developers think that 2.0 and Python 3.0 has similar capabilities. No, the Python 2.0 has a different syntax and Python 3.0 has a different syntax. In these, in our video series, we are going to learn about Python 3.0 series. And somehow, it seems that all the syntax is same, but some of the syntax is different when we compare to Python 2.0 and Python 2.3. I mean, Python 3.0. Identifiers. Here's come the main major role, identifiers. A name in the Python is called identifier. Let's take here an example. For example, A is equal to 10. Here A is an identifier. 10 with the help of A is 10 is the identifier with the help of A. See, 10 is the name of A. Let me take, my name is Dinesh. I am your instructor. In my home or my relatives or my neighbors call me as Dinesh with the help of my identifier, my name. See, name is an identifier, my name, like that. Let me discuss rules for the Python identifiers or rules to create identifiers. Like even my father has kept, my parents has kept me Dinesh name. When it comes to, if like taken an example, X person name has an Steins or any Zuckerberg or any Bill Gates. If a person, her parents are, her parents kept his name combination of special characters or digits, it will be very good to see. No, it is not wrong. The person name should be consist of only letters. There is certain rules. The person name should not be equal to animal names or any plain names like that, bird names like that. There is a certain rules to kept a name for a person, for a child, like that only. When it comes to identifiers, there are certain rules. You have to create an identifier, create a variable with 0 to z, small 0 to small z, capital A to, I mean capital z, 0 to 9 and underscore, explicitly underscore also we can use as a rules for to create an identifier. Let me take here is an example that cash is equal to 10. It is absolutely correct. It is absolutely correct. See here another one, cash dollar hash, cash CA dollar H is equal to 20. It is wrong because of the dollar has not in the rules, is not in the rule, so it is wrong. All at the rate hands, it is also wrong because of see here at the rate is not in the rule of creation of identifier. And if we had used any other symbol, the syntax error will be raised. See here, let me take another example. Total 1, 2, 3 is equal to 10. It is absolutely correct. It, we had used in small letters, capital letter and integers. When it comes to here also we had taken small letters and integers. But the starting letters is in integers. that's why the PVM has a Python virtual machine has raised an error. We do not have a rights to use integers in starting because of identifier should not start with digits. Let me take another example. Capital T, small o, small t, small a, l, small l. Is equal to 10. It is absolutely correct. Here is a combination of capital one letter and multiple zeros, and then total is equal to 20. Here is an only combination of small letters, and then total 40. It is a combination of capital letters. Please note that Python identifiers are case sensitive. There is no length limit for Python identifiers. X is equal to 10 if is equal to 20. See here, before example, x is equal to 10, it is absolutely correct. It is in capital letter. If is equal to 20, it is wrong because of it is a keyword. There are almost 33 keywords are there. Let me discuss about keywords. The keyword which are reserved to represent some meaning or some functionality. Let me spell out all the keywords: false, avoid, else, import, pass, none, break, except, in, arise, true, class, finally, is, written, and, continue, for, lambda, try, as, def, from, non-local, while, asset, del, global, not, with, async, elif, if, or, yield. These are the keywords. Every single keyword has a definition. The false has a certain rules. The if statement, if has a certain rule. Global has certain rules. Let me see. All the keywords are contains only alphabets only, not consists of any or even integers or underscores. It is the combination of alphabets only. Python keywords and their uses. Value keyword, true, false, none. These are the value keywords. Operator keyword and or, not, in, is. These are the operator keywords. Flow control keywords, if, elif, else. Iteration keywords, for, while, break, continue, else. Structure keywords, def, class, with, as, pass, lambda. These are the structure keywords. Returning keywords, return and yield. These two are the returning keywords. Import keywords. This will help to import the libraries. Import from, as. These three are the import keywords. Exception handling keywords. Exception handling means this is a very vast topic in programming languages or in any programming language. When it comes to C, C++, Java, .NET or Python, any programming language, exception handling will come in a very critical area. We have to take in concentration here only. Try, accept, arise, false, finally, else, asset. These are the exception handling keywords. Asynchronous programming keywords, async and await. Variable handling keywords. That means del, it is a function name. With the help of del, we can create a functions global. It seems that use of the global. Under the global, is there any variables? Means that variables can access all over the program. Non-local means if we had used the non-local in any function, under that that function non-local only will take that ones. These are the keywords in Python. The next topic is about data types. Let me see you in next video series.